How would you describe your mood in three words? Just slightly caffeinated, maybe. What's the best part about being a developer? I love the part creative, part technical, just getting to solve really interesting problems for a living is really cool. What are you currently reading? I'm not really reading anything right now. I'm really excited for the next Stormlight Archive book by Brandon Sanderson that comes out this fall. Really looking forward to that. Which language is the best for an absolute beginner? This is tough. Honestly, I think the language that sounds interesting to you, like genuinely, like you could start in anything, I think. And as long as you're building a thing that seems interesting and is going to drive you towards, you know, it's going to help you push yourself to doing more and more, I think that's going to be that's the key. Android or iPhone? iPhone for now. Thinking about making the switch here in the fall when my contract is up. What are a few of your favorite tools and why? For coding, like my bread and butter tool is Binding Pry, which is just this little debugger tool to, hey, stop the code here so I can see like what variables are defined as what at what place. That I'm using that all the time. What would you do in life if money weren't an issue? I'd probably spend more time at Disneyland and just traveling with family and stuff. I don't know. That's weird, though. Money not being an issue. I'm not sure what I would do. Who was your favorite teacher? In fifth grade, I had this amazing teacher, Mrs. Shimke. She was great. She was supportive. Fifth grade was this really like weird transitional time in my life. So she was, I don't know. I was an awkward kid and she was just really kind. So I appreciate it. If you're watching, Mrs. Shimke, you made an impact. What inspired you to learn to code? It seemed interesting. I was a math nerd in high school and I liked that stuff. And so, but I never got into it. I used to like copy down like things on my TI calculator, but I never knew any of it. So I just kind of, when I was looking to change careers, I just decided, well, I like computers, so let's explore what this is. So that was kind of it. Nothing spectacular or crazy. What is the best band or musician in all of history? I don't know if I can answer this. I have a soft place in my heart for a couple of bands from my childhood. Manowar is one of the best metal bands, I think, from that era. And I also, from my high school years, Switchfoot is like the band that I probably listened to almost exclusively. I listened to a lot of Switchfoot back in the day. Nowadays, like, I don't know. Whatever. The Beatles are the best. There you go. What is your greatest challenge as a developer? The greatest challenge is that is the crushing feeling of not feeling like you know everything that you should know. So just that, like, just sometimes it can be really overwhelming. Like, oh, well, there's always this new technology and I don't know how to like learn it fast enough. That usually is just in moments and then that settles down and I realize, oh, it's okay if I don't know everything. But dealing with that can be really, really challenging. What are you looking forward to learning this year? I am looking forward to learning. I'm interested in learning some functional programming. I'm interested in just kind of continuing to learn just more about my everyday work. That's kind of it. Oh, I'm super interested in getting more into just like statistics and statistical analysis. I'm really interested in machine learning and I'd love to like just get into like building data models and things like that. I have very, very little knowledge about that stuff, but it's super fascinating to me. So that's what I'm interested in learning this year. Where would you like to travel next? So my wife and I have this plan for next summer. It's our 15th anniversary, and we want to take a trip to Scotland and do a like distillery tour and go from like, you know, Islay and then onto the mainland and then hopefully get all the way up north to like Old Putney is this like really cool distillery. Well, their whiskey is good at least. So that's kind of, that's our next big like planned adventure. We have a friend who said that the way to do it right is you do 3 distilleries to 1 castle, and then that's how you travel Scotland. So I'm looking forward to that. If you were to give yourself advice back when you were a kid, what would you say? I would say don't worry so much about trying to fit in with other people. Like, because eventually that matters so little, and spending so much of your time and energy trying to like just be one of the crowd is actually like kind of, it's just not worth it. So that's what I would tell. That's what I would tell little Dustin if I could go back. What web browser do you use? Chrome. Chrome is what the web browser I use. What is your routine for getting ready to code? I don't really have one. I like to have coffee next to me. That's the big thing. But I don't really have like a whole like setup that I get. I kind of move around a lot. So Mac or PC, I use a Mac. What accomplishment are you most proud of? What accomplishment am I most proud of? Honestly, probably my kids. Like, that's such like a lame dad answer, but I can't think of anything that I've done that's better than those people. So what do you think is going to be the most interesting development in technology in the next 5 years? I don't know. I'm not a futurist. I think there's interesting things happening with like machine learning, but I'm not like, I don't think AI robots are going to be taking over the world in 5 years. I have no idea. I really don't. What would you order for your last meal? I'd probably do a nice medium rare ribeye steak with some mashed red potatoes with the skin still on them, and then maybe some asparagus or Brussels sprouts or some like kind of like buttery green vegetable on the side. That would be nice.